Let me say that we've been dealing here in Venice, in the Lagoon, Veneto region, with similar problems. Obviously, we have different population, different density, but the environment that surrounds us is very fragile as well. And many of the challenges that you pointed out are very similar for various reasons to what we have to deal with here in Venice. But you know, let's have your counterpart, your discussant, say a few words about your experience and also about this relationship that has been established with Italy, with the Italian government, which is a very interesting one and relevant, it seems.
I would like to introduce you Montenegro. Very nice country. I want to say that maybe you have to visit Montenegro because Predrag Nenezic was very prudent in showing Montenegrinian beauties. I have some consideration, taking into account our experience in Montenegro in the last 7 years. When we started to work in Montenegro, Montenegro was a state in the federal state of former Yugoslavia. And the situation in the region, in the country, was the situation of a country five years after the war, more or less. And Montenegro at that time had many opportunities. One of the opportunities of Montenegro was to be the base for industrial investments from the European countries for the delocalization of the most polluted industries. Because at that time many companies in Italy, in Austria, in Germany, were looking at Western Balkans as a possible base for the relocation of the most polluted industries they have in the countries. And this, at that time, could be an attractive perspective for the economic restoration of the country after the war. What I can say and what I appreciated at the time and I appreciate now today is that Montenegro was very clear. I remember they told me first time we are a green country, we want to link our economic growth with the protection of the environment. We consider the protection of the environment as a very basic resource for our economic growth. I believe that what is happening now in Montenegro is a very interesting case in Europe because they are investing in the protection of the environment as a tool for the economic growth. Working in two parallel tracks. From one side, they are trying to restore what they destroyed in the past under the former Yugoslavia, when the coastal zone of Montenegro was used for as a touristic, a popular touristic area for all the country, with a lot of damages. Some of damages is a typical damage of the former socialism state. Big buildings, very, very hard impact on the territory and so on. And so this is one way they are following. And it's an art task, but they are improving with a very interesting positive effect, this tax. Restore the former installations for the touristic activities. The other track is what Minister Nenesi said. They are working in order to attract investors for building green areas for the touristic development, both in the mountains and in the coastal zone. And I believe that this is the reason why we are working in Montenegro, we will stay in Montenegro. Because we are a part of a very innovative experiment, because they have the potential for a very strong economic growth using the natural resources as the raw materials for the increasing of the production. The production is the increasing of the revenues from the tourism. And my suggestion is to link the Venice International University with this program. When I saw first time the Cutter Bay, I imagine what the Venetians, I believe 4 centuries ago, saw and imagined. Because when the Venetians arrived in Cutter Bay, they started to build a small city like Venice. The relationship between Venice and Cutter Bay is peculiar, because the Republic of Venice started to build in Cutter Bay another city like Venice. And maybe you know that the last city in the Republic of Venice was Cutter. When the Republic of Venice ended, Qatar stayed as the last city of the Republic of Venice. And so we are looking, we are the partners of a very singular process in Europe. We are supporting a country in addressing the sustainable development using the tourism, using the improvement of local production in agriculture, using the best low impact practices. We are the partner in the process designing new style in the building, new technologies. And at the same time, I believe that we could be a partner in the process for the restoration of the cultural heritage of Montenegro, taking into account that the cultural heritage of Montenegro is a Venetian heritage. And so this is a good reason for a strong relationship between Venice and Montenegro. And I think that Italian students working in Italy, studying in Italy, in Venice, could join with very interesting results. The such a process in Montenegro. And this is the reason why I strongly support the partnership between Predrag Nenezić and the Venice University, International University. That's all.